even a Ouija board?
Doesn't matter.
Okay, so you know how to play, right?
We just put our hands on the pointer and ask it questions and it moves, right?
Well, it's called a planchette, but more or less, we just have to move it around before we summon the spirits.
Don't we need, like, candles or something for this to work?
No. That's for, like, movies and witchcraft and stuff. This is just a game. It's not even real.
Well, then do we have to play with the lights off? Okay, just asking.
Okay. You ready? We have to say Ouija 3 times for this to work.
Ouija, Ouija, Ouija.
Are there any spirits with us? If there are, can you give us a sign?
Okay, this is stupid, Heidi.
Okay, you have to wait a second. You have to be patient with these kind of things.
Oh, what? Like you're an expert on seances now?
Okay, first of all, seances are just a group of people sitting around a table looking into a crystal ball, all right? This is a board game, Gabby. It's not real, okay? Let's try it again.
Ouija. Ouija. Ouija.
I call upon the spirits of the dead. If there are any with us, please make yourself known.
You just moved it.
No, I didn't.
Stop playing games with me, Heidi.
I seriously did not move it.
This isn't funny. You always do this.
I never do this.
You always try to make a bar.
You're sitting in the closet playing a game.
Heidi.
I never do this.
Okay, let's just put it up and prove
your point. No, wait. I want to see what he wants.
I don't think that's a very good idea, Heidi.
Don't be such a baby.
No, I'm not playing anymore.
Are you a ghost? Guess that's a no.
What's your name?
Okay, if you're gonna ask it questions, you have to put your hand on the planchette.
What's your name?
R. A. Y. M. O. N. D.
Raymond, that's not even a scary name. Okay, Ray, what do you want?
Behind me.
I thought you said you heard something.
I did.
What are you freaking out about?
You didn't see that?
See what?
There was a man standing right behind you.
There's no one behind me, Gabby. Okay, that's just a stupid game. I was just doing this to get a rise out of you. Don't you think you're over-dramatizing this just a little?
Thank you.
Hey, heads up.
Thanks.
Oh, I should have got you any more cigarettes while you were in there.
It's okay. I'm sure there's still some more in there. You can grab some more right before we leave.
Nah, just bump some at the lake.
Oh, speaking of, are you still not coming on the yacht with me and Samantha?
No, I don't do boats. The last thing I need is to be seasick all day.
Aw, come on, dude. Rent it out for everybody. It's gonna be fun.
None of your daddy's money can get me on a boat for the entire day.
None of it?
Well, it would have to be a lot.
Alright, well, you know what? If you're not gonna come on the yacht, then you get to drive the rest of the way. And I get to bum off these all day.
Sounds fair.
Hey, Shane? Shane?
What?
Have you seen my Barry Dixon book?
I don't even know what that is, Mom.
It's a thick white interior design book. I thought about remodeling the upstairs hallway.
No, I haven't. Did you ask Blake?
I'll try calling, but I doubt she'll answer.
Where is she?
So, are you coming out to the bar with me and Samantha tonight?
No, actually, because remember, I'm leaving tomorrow to go out of town.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
It's Buena, so it's about 3-4 hours north of here. I rented a cabin for a couple of weeks.
Are you going with, like, family or something?
No, it's actually to, get away from the family for a little while, if you know what I mean.
So, wait. You got a cabin to yourself for 2 weeks, and you weren't planning on telling me?
I don't know, it's like a farm, so...
A farm?
Yeah, I just didn't think you would be interested.
2 weeks is a while. What's something like that cost?
No, I actually got a pretty good deal on it. The place has been vacant for 2-3 years, so.
Yeah. You definitely haven't been living here long enough if you consider that a vacation.
Yeah, no. Honestly, it's just for some peace and quiet. It's kind of what I need right now.
Yeah, I imagine so, moving into that creepy house.
What do you mean?
You haven't heard the stories? So there's this urban legend that we were told as kids about a woman in a black dress that haunts the house. They say her husband had all these affairs around town that it drove her mad, so much so that she up and killed herself. But that's not the worst part. He took off her favorite necklace that was handed down from her grandmother while they were burying her. And they say anyone who has it, she kills them.
Okay, so what? There's like a dead woman living in my house?
Well, technically, you're living in her house.
Right. I mean, you don't really take that stuff seriously, do you?
Like I said, just kid stories. But I will tell you this, that necklace she always wore, they never recovered it. Can you imagine what something like that is worth?
All right. Well, you know what? If I find it, it's all yours.
Thank you. Thought you said you were quitting.
This is me quitting. Thought you were quitting sodas.
Well, see, Mom, I'm in college. I don't know what you think I used to stay up late studying with.
Don't come whining to me when you get diabetes.
Yeah, you were totally getting lung cancer before I ever get diabetes.
Probably.
Hey.
What are you doing out here?
Nothing.
Well, it's gotta be something if you're out here in the dark and not inside.
I'm just not used to it here, I guess.
Oh. Yeah, it's a little bit different, for sure.
He was the only one there when I won these.
Come here. Miss Dad, too. You know it's been hard on everybody, Shane.
Please. You've hardly shown any emotion since it happened.
You just gotta understand that we show everything in our own way, you know? Doesn't mean it hasn't affected me, too. But, listen, I was thinking, and I know we haven't spent a lot of time together since I got back from school, and I was thinking after I get back from the cabin, I was wondering if me and you wanted to do something together, like old times.
Like old times?
Yep. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. It's a plan. Home sweet home. Thank you.
Hello.
Hey, what's up?
Hey. Just getting settled in. What are you up to?
Bored out of my mind. Mom is driving me crazy with this remodel stuff.
Why don't you call up your friends and go hang out?
All my friends are 40 minutes away and I don't have a driver's license.
Well, I mean, if you want to and if you can get someone to take you over here, I can text you the address and you can stay up here for a few days.
That would be awesome. Mom?
Hang on, Blake.
Mom, can you keep it down? I'm on the phone. Mom? Mom, are you there?
Okay, I'm back.
Is everything okay over there?
Yeah, I think there's a cat in the attic or something.
Oh my god. I'm so glad I don't have to be home
to deal with that right now.
Blake?
Alright, hang on, Shane. My phone's dying.
Blake, can you hear me?
Hello? Are you there?
Hello?
Hello?
That was amazing.
Aren't I always? Who's that?
Nobody. Phone bill's late. Need some water. Want anything to drink?
No, I'm good.
I really have to get out of this town, Sam. I can't keep dodging these eviction notices.
Well, come work with me at Spanky's.
Excuse me, but I'm not a stripper.
Neither am I.
Bartending around a bunch of naked bitches all night while they make money? Not my idea of fun.
Well, why don't you move in with Tommy?
Why would I do that?
Aren't y'all a thing?
When have you ever known me to be into Tommy?
Haven't y'all hooked up?
Once or twice doesn't make us a thing.
Well, shit. Short of robbing a bank, I don't know how you're gonna make any money around here.
Holy shit, that's genius.
What, you're gonna rob a bank?
No, of course not. I'm gonna rob Blake.
Whoa, wait. Blake?
Yeah, why not? She's loaded, right? And she just moved into the old Hughes house.
Right, but you and I are basically the only two people she knows around here. Plus, we both know she's loaded.
What about the guy that your stepdad hired to take care of that thing for him?
What about him?
Can he help us?
Well, I can ask, but I don't recommend getting involved with him.
He's just helping us out. We get the money. He takes care of Blake. He gets a cut. We walk away scot-free. And I leave this place.
Now we're getting rid of Blake?
Occupational hazard.
Well, if you think it'll work,
oh, it'll work.
Shit.
So that's where she put them.
Jason said the power's out in 3 counties.
It's not out here.
Chloe. Chloe.
What?
What are we doing here?
We aren't doing anything.
Whoa, wait. I thought you said you were gonna...
Gonna what?
No.
Really?
What?
Keep thinking with your dick and see where that gets you. No service. No service. No service. Fantastic.
Seriously, where's the money? Bingo.
Sorry, honey.
Had to get rid of your booty call.
How was the search? Did you find anything in the house?
Not as much as I needed. Any word on your end?
Yeah, the guy's on his way to take care of Blake, but we really need to have that money for him.
And if we don't?
If we don't? This isn't a guy you want to play games with. If we don't have something for him after already hiring him, he's gonna come after both of us.
I'm gonna go up there.
Chloe, I don't think that's a smart idea.
What's the worst that could happen?
He finds you without his money, and he comes after both of us. I'm stuck in this with you too, Chloe.
Don't be so melodramatic. I can take care of myself.
So what are you gonna do?
I'm gonna go get our money.
This way.
Hey, I know you're there. Come on.
Thank you.
Hey. It's okay, I'm not gonna hurt you. My name's Blake, what's your name? Is this yours? Yeah? You want it back? It's okay, I'm not gonna hurt you, you can have it. What's your name?
Danielle.
Danielle, huh? That's pretty. What are you doing out here in the rain, Danielle?
It's not safe here.
Do you know what happened to the two sisters that lived here a few years back?
They brought her here. They used the game and brought her back.
What game?
They sent them a message with the letters on the floor.
Are you talking about the Ouija?
Don't say its name! You should never say its name, nor play with its evil.
I don't understand, Danielle.
Burn the game.
Are you fucking kidding me right now?
She's back.
Who's back? Who's she?
She is bad. Very, very bad.
What are you doing here?
Let's cut the bullshit. I need to get what I came here for. You're my only ticket out of this town.
What are you talking about? Please put that...
The money, Blake. You're the only one here that has any.
Money? I mean, I have $100 in my wallet.
Ugh, fucking hell! I can go get that for you right now.
That's not the kind of money that I'm talking about.
Okay, I can get you to the car, we can go to the ATM, I can get you cash.
This is what we're gonna do. What was that?
Thank you. know somebody's up here. This isn't funny.
What?
Thank you.
food.
This. You're tough. Where's Sam, Chloe, and all the money?
What money? I don't know what you mean.
You know, I usually don't like to hurt women. But if you don't tell me where Chloe is, I'm gonna get a little angry.
I heard someone screaming from the barn. It ran over there. Please, listen to me, okay? There's strange things going on here. We have to get out of here.
Let me tell you a story that you probably don't know. You see, your friend, Chloe, she played you, went to your house, and now she's missing. And you're running off like you've seen a ghost or something.
I'm telling you, I don't know where Chloe is. I don't know. Just let me go. Please. Please.
You and I both know I can't do that. Not after you've seen my face. So I'm going to ask you one more time. Where's Chloe?
She's gone. If Samantha had stolen any money, she should have shit! Didn't tell me where they put it!
You're probably right. But unfortunately for you, I drove out here to get something. I think we're gonna have to postpone our engagement just a little bit longer. But don't you worry, sweet cheeks. I'll be back.
Mm-hmm.
Blake? Blake?
Mm-hmm.